And it's fantasy and it's fun, but it's so wearable. It's so real too. It's so real clothes. It's not complete frivolity. I mean, there's a place for like the complete frivolity too. But there's a woman who buys a Chanel couture suit, and I think that's so important. That one, the garments I always wish I had designed with the original Halston clothes, I think are amazing. You know, a vintage Halston dress is like genius. It has that same idea as Balenciaga. Of the fluidity, and you know, few seams and just a great cut, you know, combined with American sportswear. And I think every time I see a vintage Halston, I'm like, oh, I can't believe he beat me to it.
You know, we have to remember that haute couture was a craft that was made for very few and very privileged.
Yeah.
You know, and that is not. But that doesn't address the realities of fashion today, you know. What happens in the runway is not fashion, it's a spectacle, you know. Fashion is once you said, gee, this will be great for me, and you decide to put it on because it's going to do something for you. Not for me, I have nothing to do with it. I'm just trying to guess what your, you know, your dreams, your aspirations, your sense of individuality. Who are you as a woman? How you want to express yourself? This is the most exciting time in history to be creating clothes.
Alan Schiaparelli was the master, but he had an incredible talent to make shape and form, also in a very soft but really much more glamorous, much more bold. I think it was much more easy to comprehend, and I think that's why he's just so popular, because his chic, his sense of color, it was very severe, it was almost religious, you know, the sensibility of his works.
It's really not about big logos, or it's about how much something costs. It's more about the timelessness of a piece.
I like to look at you when you think you're alone. I like to look at you.